may I speak with Bobby or Sarah? This is Shelley from the Glengarry Group. Is this Mrs. Billingsley?
Yes, David Moss from the Glengarry Group. I'm looking for Little Butch. He's expecting my call.
I tell you what, you tell Sophie that Glengarry from the George Aeronaut Group, George Aeronaut from the Glengarry Group called. I have some terrific toy opportunities for her, but they're not going to last long. You tell her it's urgent. Can you tell her that, sweetheart? Is this the older sister by any chance? I thought so. How are you, darling?
Looking back, the big change in Christmas was inevitable. The relentless commercialization of the holidays and the incumbent pressure to re-energize lagging economies year after year met the financial collapse of 2037, and a Christmas backlash was created. A tsunami of spiritual destruction that left December a barren, lonely month. Slowly, Christmas was resurrected, but with strict financial regulations in place to guide the touching of the spirit each year. Chief among these regulations was the issuance of Santa dollars to each child under 12, from which toys and other amusements could be purchased. No clothes or shoes or school supplies, those were provided by the government. Toy manufacturing was shifted from the North Pole to any number of third world toy factories. Delivery was outsourced and reindeer died off. Santa became an even more useless icon, much like Colonel Sanders in his final days. Elves became salesmen, devious and single-minded, obsessed with commissions and the magic sale. The Glengarry Group was one of the most ruthless of those companies.
So, you didn't actually talk to him about it. How do you know he's going to buy them?
I don't. We're just talking here.
What could we get for them, the leads?
20. That's 25 if they're good. Altogether, that would make us about 10 large.
You're saying an elf could take these leads and sell them to the Father Christmas Group?
That's what I'm saying.
Wait, are we just talking about it, or are we talking about it?
I'm just saying that an elf could take them, like anything else negotiable, with value, and sell them to FCG.
Speaking about it as an idea, not actually talking about it, about a robbery.
Robbery? No. It's a crime. A crime that happens to be very safe.
You're actually talking about this? About stealing the leads from Glengarry?
Have I said that? Did I say that?
Did you talk to someone at FCG about this?
He'd buy them.
Let me have your attention. You're talking about what? Complaining about some sale you shot? Some kid who didn't want to buy your toy? Some broad who wouldn't open the front door for you and all that? Let's talk about something important. They all here?
All but one.
Well, I'm gonna start anyway. Let's talk about something important. Put that eggnog down. You think I'm fudging with you? Eggnog's for closers only. I'm not fudging with you. I'm here from up north. I'm here for St. Nick and I am on a mission of mercy. Your name's Shelley?
Yeah.
You call yourself one of Santa's elves?
I don't have to put up with this spit.
You sure don't, pal, because the good news is you're fired. The bad news is you have exactly 1 week to regain your job. 1 week starting with tonight. Starting with tonight's sit.
Oh.
Do I have your attention now? Good. You got leads. You can't close the leads you're given. You can't close spit. You are spit. Hit the snow, little man, and beat it, because you're going out.
The leads are weak.
Fudging leads a week? You're...
What's your name?
Happy Kwanzaa. That's my name. You know why, buddy? Because you rode a donkey to get here tonight. I rode an $80,000 DeVille sled. That's my name. And your name, mister, is your wanting. You can't play in the elf's game. You can't close them. And go home and tell your wife your troubles. Because only one thing counts in this game. Get them to sign on the line which is dotted. You hear me, you fudging holly jollies? A, always. B, B. C, cheery. Always be cheery. Always be cheery. What's the problem, pal?
You're such a hero. You're so cheery. How come you're coming down here to waste time with us bums?
You see this watch? You see this watch? This watch costs more than your donkey. I sold toys to 5,000 kids last year, buddy. How many did you sell to? Happy Elf? I don't give a spit. Good caroler? Fudge you! Go home and sing with your kids. You want to work here, little man? Cheer! You think this is abuse? You think this is abuse, little man? You don't like it? Leave! I can go out there tonight with the materials you got and sell 500 stocking stuffers. Tonight, in 2 hours. Can you? Can you? Go and do likewise, elves. ABC. ABC. Get cheery, little men. Get cheery. Get cheery. Do you know what it takes to sell Christmas gifts? Brass bells. It takes brass bells to sell Christmas gifts. Go and do likewise, elves. Witches are out there. Pick them up, and they're yours. You don't? I have no cheer for you.
Hi, little Cindy Lou. I'm Shelley, and I was talking with your brother Billy earlier.
Come in, please.
Ah, a rail fan. I myself used to build wooden trains years ago. That's a beauty. Where's Billy?
I'm sorry. Who are you and what is this about?
I'm Shelley, and I'm with the Glenmary Group down just for the evening, and I spoke with your brother Billy over the phone earlier.
Oh yeah, he says he won some toys as an award?
A consultant came by the Glenmary Group a couple of days ago and offered to pay me $2 million to promote his toy division. And you know what I said? I said, spit. I can save you $2 million, pass it on to the kids with their Santa dollars. And he said, wow, you can do this without advertising in TV? You have a toy this great? And I said, I'll tell you what we do. We talk to the kids, you know, the kids you used to carol with, and we talk to them direct, and then we pass the savings on directly to them. Rebates.
So you want to sell my brother toys?
Oh, Grinch, no. I'll leave that to the sales elves. I wouldn't try to do that.
Listen, mister, Billy and I are having a sleepover tonight, so you better be going.
Well, great. I'll go get in my PJs. I love a slumber party, and after talking with Billy over the phone, I can hardly wait to meet him.
No, stranger danger!
Oh, I'm sorry, Cindy Lou. I didn't want to spoil your cheer. It's just that I don't want you to lose this opportunity. But since I can't talk to Billy, I tell you what, I'll make the offer to you. That way, you both can enjoy it together.
No, I don't want to buy your crummy toys, and neither does Billy. Now go!
I'm a busy man, and I know you're a busy girl. I just want to give this gift away.
All toy stores smell vaguely like chocolate. It's to whet your appetite. Get so you don't even notice it anymore. Took me a long time to realize this. When you grow up, you're gonna regret the things you don't do as a kid. Your name is Jack. You want to be Jill. It's okay. You cheat at kickball. We all do. You get befuddled by this North Pole morality. Shudder it. Shudder it out. Live with it. You still get a toy. You ever fart so hard you crack your back?
No, I think so.
Great candy fades upon reflection. Great toys gain. Great toys you may have had. What do you remember about them?
What do I remember?
I don't know. For me, it's not playing with it. It's probably opening it up on Christmas Day. The smell of it coming out of the package. the first time I show it to my friends. What is our life? Our life is like looking through the windshield or the rear view. It's it. This is it. Where's the moment? What are we afraid of? A bully taking our milk money? A monster in the closet? Pop quiz on Tuesday? Now, these things happen. We worry. Why?
Oh, no, 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 my friend. You are not getting out from under this one. This has your name written all over it. Now, I know you're lying to me.
What the fudge is this?
We were robbed last night. Somebody broke in and took everything.
Well, what about Max's Santa dollars? Mm-hmm. The kid I closed last night? You didn't deposit those Santa dollars before you went home?
I locked them in my desk to deposit this morning. The Santa dollars are gone, along with the Glenn Claus leads.
You didn't deposit the Santa dollars last night before you went home. Look, I took that kid for everything he had last night. That better go on my sales. I am not losing this top prize.
Hey, don't be so self-centered. We all lost something here last night, not just you. And you know how it works. No money in the bank, the sale doesn't count.
Fudge you! What the fudge is that? Sale doesn't count! No. Look here, Chestnuts. You know, I'm gonna have you fired. I don't care whose nephew you are. Because nobody can be this incompetent.
What the spit happened here?
We were robbed last night. They took everything.
Seriously?
No, he's joking. He was visited by three ghosts last night. And this is the aftermath of the Ghost of Christmas Present.
Hey, hey, hey! The police are here to figure out what happened. They're talking to George right now, and they're going to want to talk to all of you, too, so settle down.
Hey, you can't talk to someone like that. It just isn't right. It isn't right. I've been here for years. I'm a fudging good elf, and they treat me like that. There is no cheer here. Cheer has left the room.
So who's next?
Oh, fudge. I'll do it.
Well, well, well. It looks like someone new is going to have to worry about losing his job. I can't imagine St. Nick wanting an office manager who fails to lock up the office. Then what are you gonna do? You have no skills, little man.
Hey, don't come after me, Shelley, like you're the picture of success. You're still the low man on the board, regardless of what happened here last night.
You just don't get it, do you? It's like your brain is candy-coated and the point can't get through. I'm a sales elf. I've got a trade. But you? What the fudge do you have? Those wind-up monkeys we used to make in the old days could do your job. As a matter of fact, they could probably do it better. You just let someone come in here and steal us blind. All our hard work, poof, gone. Like a fart in the wind. Santa dollars, gone. And along with it, the Christmas spirit that was going to carry us through. And you're standing there like your stockings don't stink.
What did you just say?
You're standing there like you're sniffing the mistletoe.
No, before that, you said that the Santa dollars were taken. How did you know that?
What?
I always lock up the Santa dollars every night, depositing them in the bank, except for last night. Romo and I were the last ones here. How did you know that Romo was the last sale that was made?
What are you blabbering about? You're trying to shift the blame.
You couldn't have known unless you were the one that broke in. I think the detectives are going to want to talk to you.
What? What did you say? Say that again.
Come along if you want to watch the show.
Now hold on, Williamson. Just a second. Maybe that candy-coated brain thing was a little overboard. But let's look at your options and what you can do to profit from them. Because you are in a position to profit from them if you understand what I'm saying.
Enlighten me.
Moss and I sold some log deals and made a pretty penny from it. Now, there's no reason why a smart elf like yourself couldn't get maybe half of that.
Done.
You have got to be kidding me.
Oh, shut up. This is what we're about. This is what we're here for, making money. Who cares what kind of a wrapper it comes in?
This is not right.
You've been steamrolling over kids for years to get to the top. So don't be touched by the fact that someone pulled one over on you for once.
But it was still all about the kids. It's not like it was in the old days. I never took a present away from a child. I always convinced him that what I had was better than what he could get down the street. But to you, a warped, frustrated old man, they're just like cattle.
I think we have a starry-eyed dreamer here, just converted. What, are you gonna start giving toys away at Christmas time now?
I don't know. Maybe I will. Yeah, maybe that's what I should do. But I'll tell you what, I'm out of here. I'm done. Fudge you, and fudge you. Goodbye. I am going to save myself while there's something worth saving.
And the first step I gotta do is to get away from you. And maybe I will start giving toys away. And maybe, just maybe, I can make people remember what Christmas was like a long time ago.
So who's next?
He did it!
The end of the Glen Mary Group. We'd like to say yes, but the lure of Santa dollars, licit or illicit, once again proved irresistible, and the company, Leeds, other assorted assets, and all were gobbled up by an international conglomerate and became so many fiscal orange slices floating in the holiday shopping punch bowl. By the way, for all you Christmas buffs, Santa dollars were outlawed 5 years after this little tale, and eventually the true spirit of the holidays returned. Santa Claus and other symbols included, due in large part to the faith that the original Christmas had so firmly implanted in all of us. So as that time of the year once again arrives, remember to keep that faith. Spend a few holiday dollars wherever you got them, and look out for the other guy, at least for a couple of weeks. He may give you some fudge.
Little green.